So the Holy Spirit is moving, and I tried to make this video earlier, but I feel like it didn't come out quite right. So I felt that I needed to go ahead and remake this video, but I really needed to go in Dollar Tree before they closed because I had to get some stuff, and I went in there, and as I was walking around the store, I noticed that I no longer had my phone, and I looked up and down the whole store for my phone, and I looked in my car, and I'm like, okay, my phone is nowhere. I'm like, can I please use your phone so that I can call my phone so I can find it, please? Because I really, really need my phone. And they said, we can't allow you to use the phone from the store, but here is my cell phone. You can go ahead and use it. And I called my phone, and my phone rang, and I went there, and it was in a box, and it was like it was deliberately covered up. Like, somebody didn't want me to have my phone. And I was like, it was in a box. I'm like, okay. And I gave the lady back her phone. I just thanked her so much for allowing me to use her phone so I could find my phone. So I really feel like the devil was trying to keep me from getting the message out there. But you know what? God is in control. And I'm so grateful that Jesus has my back, and he already has it worked out to where I can be used for his kingdom, his honor, his praise, and his glory. And I am so happy. I'm really, really just happy that I belong to Jesus. And no matter what the devil throws at me, I belong to him, and everything is going to always be worked out for my good. But most importantly, his kingdom, his honor, his praise, and his glory. I'm so happy about that. But anyways, the Holy Spirit is just sending me a message. Keep watch. Keep looking. Stay focused on Jesus. We are in October, and I just get this feeling in my spirit that we are about to see some crazy things, and we just need to keep looking for the day of the rapture and not to fear the things that are seem like they are going to come against us, because Satan has a plan, and Satan wants his plan to come to fruition. He wants it to come to pass now, before the rapture, before God gives him the permission to carry out his 7-year tribulation plan. So keep your eyes focused on Jesus, because we belong to him, and we are going to be as in the days of Noah, eating, drinking, giving in marriage, living our daily lives like we don't have a care in the world. But we see the storm is brewing. This, and you know what? When you get a big storm, before the rain falls, I mean, if it's a big storm, it's going to last you a long, long time. Like, we had a big storm when I first moved to where my current home so many years ago. It rained for a month straight without stopping. And that storm built up for a very long time. I mean, it had to simmer and build and collect all that rainwater so it could re-release it. But we are building up, and there's a big storm coming. And it's got to build up 7 years. Of downpour. And I feel like the Holy Spirit is telling me to use a storm for what is coming, because the 7 years of tribulation is so big. And in the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. That just really came to my soul and my spirit. I feel it. The spirit realm is moving. Things are getting organized. The rains are about to fall. Not like actual rain, but the rain of a 7-year tribulation is about to fall upon the earth. And right now, we see that things are falling into place. We see the 7 years of tribulation building up like no other. And it is about that storm that is building, which is the Antichrist storm. It cannot fall yet, but yet we see it just grow, and it is about to burst upon the earth. But what is going to trigger the start of that big rain of the trouble? The rapture of the church. Stay prayed up. Stay looking. Keep your eyes focused on Jesus. He is coming like a thief in the night. Hallelujah. I am waiting on my King, my Lord, my Savior, my Redeemer to come snatch us up. That way, Satan can have his reign. His 7 years, and we can be at the marriage supper of the Lamb. I am so ready for the marriage supper of the Lamb. I am so ready for Jesus to send his only begotten Son to... I will say this, my neighbor has a cool display, but at the same time, my spirit is like, No, that's not something you want to get into, because they have like a skeleton and a witch's cauldron, which looks really cool for a display, but it is pure wicked, it's pure evil, and the Lord is just really giving me a warning. Stay away. Oh, I gotta back this up to the